On a to know that the Christian bishop prayed to see it happen in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Let's say amen.
Amen.
Let's say amen. So amen. You need to find your faith. Number three, be God kingdom minded. Be God kingdom minded. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and all his righteousness, and all things shall be added unto you. God will not give anything to somebody that will destroy his kingdom. If God knows your heart as a wicked person, he will not give you the blessing. He will not give you the blessing to those who are ready to use their money to preach the gospel. Who are ready to use their time when they are needed to serve. Otherwise, it will be like Pharaoh that will be killed before his word can be used. Why must you be killed before your time? Please, see people, the kingdom of God, and all the righteousness means everything that pertains to godliness, everything that is in the heart of God, do like this. Unforgiveness out of the way, malice and jealousy out of the way, be God centered. And God will bless the name of Jesus Christ. Number four, renew your mind. Renew your mind. We learned this morning for the school. Romans 12:2. Be renewed your mind. It means you cannot be carrying the mentality of defeat and expect to be successful. Your mentality has to be I'm a blessed child of God. Your mentality has to be I'm healed. I will not be demonized. I am great. Let that be your mentality. I don't care the state you find yourself. You shall become victorious in the name of Jesus. Amen. You shall become victorious in the name of Jesus Christ. Renew your mind. Let that old mind of defeat and negativity let it pass over.
Amen.
Please renew your mind. Number five is revelation. 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 1 Corinthians chapter 9. I read from 9 to 12. 1 Corinthians 9. 1 Corinthians chapter 2, 9 to 12. Say, but as it is written, I have not seen, nor hear harm, neither is entered into the eyes of man the things which God has prepared for them that walk in. But God has revealed them unto us by His Spirit. Now we have received the Spirit which of God, that we might know the things that freely given unto us of God. Amen. Praise the Lord. You need revelation. You need revelation. You need revelation. That is why I was once praying in Ephesians chapter 1, 18, that God will bless us wisdom and understanding the knowledge of Him. You need revelation. God will reveal to you the plans of your enemies. God will give you the insight of what you must do in your life. The woman called me and told me the dream she had. When she told me the dream she had, that dream was clouded in some mysteries, but God was telling her what she needed to do in her life. God is telling her the business she's been getting. When you get the revelation where you are going, your life is better. You need your eyes to open. And I pray in the name of Jesus Christ that this service, God Almighty, will open your eyes in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Number six is service. 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 Amen. Your service to God will determine how far you can go with God. In the book of Hebrews 12:28, you need Hebrews 12:28. Your service, our service to God must be acceptable for us to qualify for the blessing of God. When you give to God an acceptable service, I'm telling you, God will reward him for just Christ. David said in Psalm 19:14, let the word of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable unto you. Psalm 19:4. Amen. It's very important that you are kept that you offer an acceptable service unto God.
Amen.
I pray every service that will be acceptable, God will not let you do in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Because look at the cross, Deuteronomy chapter 28:47-48. Write in your mind. Deuteronomy 28:47-48. It because thou did not serve the Lord, thy God with joy and gladness of heart, for the abundance of all things, say thou that serve thy enemies, whom the Lord will send upon thee in hunger and thirst and nakedness and in want of all things. And he shall put the iron yoke upon thy neck till he comes. I pray this will not be a portion of the name of Jesus Christ. We serve God with all gladness. In fact, the Bible records that we need to give to God joyfully. We will seek to God with joyfully. Amen. Your service is very important. And lastly, your giving. Amen. Your giving. They find out that Jews, they are the most blessed of all races in the world today. Why? Because they are giving culture. Most of our giving we see now is from Judaism. Giving is very important. Amen. I say all the time, please do not be an emotional giver. Amen. Emotional giving many times do not attract blessings. You must give. Give intellectually. Give as a covenant giver. Amen. Be a covenant giver of your time. Bless your wife because it's marriage is a covenant. Say, woman, what you are doing for me, I don't like it. Just because of God. If not because of God, I would have done this, but I must bless you. Amen. Amen. Your children, let it be a covenant. Amen. In your business, be a covenant giver. Do it by covenant. Even when I come to church, let it be a covenant because you are your time. You could be in your house, listen to somebody.